Hello all, Kim K here, come with another Dead by Daylight video. And this time I'm playing the hack, so alright, let's go. I'm going to play the trap here. This is the strategy of the hack that we are going to do. I'm now going, and that is placing traps, and this is why I'm also going into this building. Because this building, which you see right now, is a loop area. It's a really strong loop area with a semi-infinite loop where survivors will guaranteed go to. That's how strong the looping is in this building. Basement. So I'm going to put traps here, trying to predict where will they go. And that is, there we got Nia. And she's going to run in a circle again. Like always. That's what they always do, run in a circle. But like I said, trying to predict where they are going with the traps. That's why I put the traps there. I slapped the bitch. She's going there. So she's planning to run again around this area. So what I'm gonna do is put a trap here to stop the loop. And now she's going into the building as predicted. I activate and I missed. And she's going through the window, which I did not, or I forgot to put it there, I don't know. And as you can see, she is going to abuse it again, the near infinite loop. So I stopped the chase, or I lost her, I think one of the two. Most likely I lost her, but I'm gonna put here a trap by the window, so I can, for the next time. And there we got Megan with her flashlight. So we're gonna go after her. She's again going to a strong loop. And she dropped the pellet early. So she's hoping to blind me. See? Gonna do here. Hopefully she will go there, but she won't. She will be waiting there and she'll keep an eye on if I come. And she choose to run and I choose to break the pellet. Keep in mind, she has a flashlight, we cannot afford to let pellets stay or else she will blind you. So, always destroy pellets when they are not there. Oh, there we got the dumbass.
Gotcha, bitch!
And we got her. So, with that being done, we did get her, that's the good thing. The one that abused the loop, so we're gonna put her between these two generators. The third one is on the building. So we're gonna do a three generator strategy. And we have to do it on this map because this map can work against you as a killer. And that is what, oh, there we got White. Let's slap him.
Ooh. Yeah, boy.
I love it. I love how that goes. Okay, put a trap here. And now we're gonna... oh, there's Mac. Let's go after Mac. And... ooh, pellet drops on me. Oh. There we got Kate. Oh my god. Can we get her? Can we get her? Yeah. She's stupid. She is so stupid. Time to hook Dwight.
Fuck this shit, I'm out.
What an asshole. Seriously, that guy is an asshole. He's a professional. Literally, a professional rage quitter. Game doesn't go how he wants, so what does he do? Oh. Pellet, but that's matter. He's a professional asshole. He quit. By the first hook, well, I got the barbecue and chip deck. Hi, Mac. And bitch near. But that guy's a pro. He's the best player in Dead by Daylight. He knows how to rage quit. Like I ranted about. Rage quit meta, people. Awesome. Really. Best players in the world are the ones that rage quit. And sarcasm. Anyway, we found the dumb gate, which is, of course, very... But can we make it into the basement? Of course we can. We gonna hang her up. Put some traps here. It's a 3 versus 4. 3 versus 4. It's a 3 versus 1. So, I got that advantage. And it did not destroy my totem. My totem is still alive. Or still up. So, that's a blessing. So I'm happy about that. So I put some traps there, so when they come, I will be there. Here a trap for Nia. Keep in mind, I keep putting traps near where they have to go. Plus, if they go there, they have to do it slowly, so I will have enough time to get there also if the tech trade. Oh. And?
You serious?
She was so determined to save Kate, but I gotta tell you people something. This Kate is so stupid. You know, not Mac. Mac thinks that she was doing good, but Mac is an idiot also. But this Kate is so stupid. I can guarantee you guys, the next time I see her, even though I know the future already, the next time we see her, she will be down again. And the time after that, I'm gonna down her again. And you will see, she is so damn stupid. There are no words for it. That's how stupid she is. And the good thing is, they wasted time to save her, so even and Dwight was still there, it would have still been a win. Okay. There we have the stupid bits. So let's see how long she will last.
Why are you running? Why are you running?
Before she even could pick up a pallet. And she's spinning around out of sheer stupidity. I think it is because she's blonde. She's a blondie, so yeah. Can't be surprised about that. Time to hook the bits. Look, the two other script factories are still there. So how long will it take me to get there? Will I walk into them or not? I won't. Actually, I don't know. Maybe they are still there or not. Did forget to put a trap on Kate, but at this point it is okay. It's okay to do it. You are allowed to make that one mistake. I'm now going back to Kate, as you can see. Let's see. It was there. Oh, I want to make that bitch is going down. Kate was in the way, so we slap her. And now we go after. And Nia is trying to force me to come towards her. I'm too smart. And I'm not gonna give Mac the chance to blind me. Okay, she left, I think. Yeah. So I'm gonna destroy this pallet. They like to use a lot of the looping areas with the pallets, so I keep destroying all the pallets. Always destroy the pallets when they are gone or something. When they are not there. And now we're gonna look for the... As you can see, I'm looking for the gate, but the problem with this map is you can easily lose sight. And I made one of the mistakes. Normally you should immediately hook them on this map, so that you don't lose them. But I was a bit too greedy. I thought I could get Mac in time, but apparently I can't, so got punished for it. Oh, there's someone, I think, or not. still looking around. So I'm going there. So where could they be? Oh, there's Mac. Look, there's Mac's fat ass. So now we're gonna slap her. If she dies, then it's over. Good trap placement. She made a mistake. I missed. But here comes the greatest part of all. She is walking to it and. That feels so good. That perfect placement. You never always place in here. Sometimes a random trap is good, but that feeling that you get that you finally teleport to that fucker and you slap the shit out of them on the floor is so satisfying. And this is what you want with Hack. You want those moments. You want those moments that make you go just to slap the back of their head, smack them on the ground, make them eat the dirt. And the best thing of all is, so it either with your prediction or just one random trap out of their own that they walk into with pure stupidity. That is so satisfying. Really so satisfying. Like and that is what you want to stay doing. You keep predicting where would they go. You place traps everywhere. On spots where you say, oh, they will go, they can't easily. Oh, this is a loop that they will use. They will use that loop. And that's how you keep playing. You keep placing your traps on those spots. I do it here, because why not? If they see you, they can then you can still teleport to them, so you close the distance a bit. And that is what you want. You want to close the distance. You want to get as close as possible. Walking around. Take the high ground to look where they are, so that you can, as you can see, there's someone. And it is.
You are so dumb. You are really dumb, for real.
The idiot Kate. The most stupid player in the team. She has the survival rate of a dodo. Like literally. A dodo has a higher chance to survive than her. Oh. I don't understand this either, because I was far away from the pallet, but it still hits me. But stupid bits will still die. Like I said, she has the survival rate of a dodo. That is how short she will live. Like, for real. Hooker. Barbecue and chili doesn't show where Nia is, so we're gonna look. And we don't know where the head is either. Maybe she knows, I don't know. Nope.
I want to die!
Okay, looks like I broke her spirit. I broke her will to live, her will to survive. Awesome. So in other words, she doesn't know where the head is. So, yeah. She doesn't know where the head sits, so. And she doesn't want to search for it in this really dark map. So, it is a win-win situation for us, because we found her. We don't have to look for the heads. Or have to worry for the heads. So, no head standoff. Awesome. Put some traps down for points. Why not? But her will was broken. Awesome shit. Easy disconnect a bit. That's what they always do. Yeah, easy disconnect. But then again, to be honest, what I said, that guy is in Ochido's team group, so that is where he learned how to disconnect as a professional. He learned it from Ochido, so hey, good job, guy. Good job for introducing the Rage Quit meta with survivors. Ruining the swamp, yep. I was lucky that the swamp was with me, that my totem was hidden in a really, really, really good spot. Because I didn't even see it, where it was. Didn't even know. I'm surprised that it even survived for so long. For like, what? 40 minutes? I think 40 minutes, yeah, 40 minutes. Still a lot. There's still a lot. Or is it 15? I forgot the count. Anyway, still it was a really good round. I kept placing my traps on locations that they will most likely go. If you also look at them, they had really strong perks like Bar of Time, Dead Heart, Self-Care, Urban Evasion and such, and even Balanced Landing. So they would have really gave me a hard time, I must have said. I must say, but we won thanks to the rage quitter of Ochido's group. Really, good job. They should keep it. They should keep turning the game into a 3-1. They could have still won, but they were too altruistic. Anyway, this was Game K saying adios, arrivederci, sayonara, auf Wiedersehen. And farewell. And see you all and next time. KMK out. And bye.